Hey guys, so we got the new to me slash on the table. I think I'm going to do what I don't like about it first. So while we was away playing, went through three Spurgies. So replacements turned up, but while looking as to why they failed, there's a bit on the gearbox that I absolutely hate. Now, the way we got around it for the weekend was by putting a bit of tape. See it. Let's try and get it right in there. So that bit of white tape you can see covers up a little hole in the gearbox case. Now that hole allows all the stuff from the drive shaft to go straight into the spur, killing the spur and pinion. Now I think that's absolutely mad. So a buddy of mine, Scott, he said get the RPM gearbox gearbox case, and they don't have that little cutout for the drive shaft. So we're now going to do a video installing this. Enjoy. So I would just like to clarify, I've never done one of these before. So wheel off, stick that in there so we don't lose it. So we'll remove the second Allen key. Gearbox cover. I'll show you that stupid little cutout. There is the cutout, and that cutout sits right over the drive shaft in the corner there. Don't know whether you can see that. Let's try and get it right in there. So you can see where the drive shaft is. Where the drive shaft sits, that cutout goes over it, and all the debris goes straight up in that hole, straight into the spur, straight into the pinion, and destroys everything. I mean, I can see already there's bits of teeth missing on this pinion, and that was maybe an hour old on the racetrack, so not good, but hopefully this sorts that. Just thought I would do this to show you guys the part numbers I've ordered. So that's for the gearbox assembly, and this is for the gearbox cover, two halves of the gearbox, bag hardware, bits. Now normally I would say I'm a man, those instructions are going in the bin. I think I might use them for this. What was that? GC, that was packaged by you. What's included? Left hand side, right hand side, motor plate. Good instructions. So let's time lapse this now, I reckon, because you don't want to watch me doing this. It's taking forever. I must have been doing this for about 10 minutes now. It's only just attaching the car. I've still got to take off what I would consider unnecessary parts to get to two little screws down the bottom. But we'll get there. Going into the spur. While it was out, just kind of had a little glance around it. You can't really see to the lights, a bit naff. But there's tons of debris in that spur gear. Absolute mad design. But hey, let's do this. That felt like it took forever, but let's get into it. Looks like, as we look at the gearbox, looks like there's just these screws here. back with backup. That was going to take forever. Remove that sticky tape to reveal a hole in the bottom of the gearbox. Surely that can't be right. So a bit of sticky tape is the only thing stopping rubbish going in there. That's another thing I hate about Traxxas. So because I'm new to the Traxxas slash world, if there's any updates, like regular maintenance I need to do, I mean, I see the diff is here. If there's anything I need to do in the diff, can you let me know in the comments, please?
Gears all cleaned, couple of dodgy bearings, got new ones there, gonna go in the case. Let's start assembling, I think.
Okay, still building the gearbox. Now,
a bit I'm struggling on, not struggling, but I'm following the instructions. The bottom one here says M3 by 10mm button head. So follow the picture there. M3 by 10, measure the button head up, perfect size. It does not go in any further than that. Poked something in there, there is definitely something stopping it. So I think that might have to be a shorter button head in that position there. Let me know how you get on, please.
Okay, run into another slight issue.
So let me break it down here. So the instructions say, just there, M4 flathead, so you pop a couple of flatheads in, they got a nut on the top of them. But where that is, that's, if you can see that, now let's try and get some light on it, that's those two there. But they don't sit flush, as you can see just there. So when you try and install them onto the rear of the chassis, it's going to sit, the cap head's going to sit with a little ridge just there, the flathead. So I'm thinking the flathead actually goes underneath this part of the chassis and through the lock, but then I'm not going to be able to get the nut on the back of them, on the top of them even. Those little nuts just there. Again, I've read the instructions umpteen times, tells me to do it this way, but I think I'm going to have to change and go right the way through the bottom of the chassis plate. Again, let me know in the comments what you guys found.
So just trying to get the screws in for the motor, and they're not sitting flush with the new heat plate. So I thought that it wasn't going in the motor far enough. But instead what I found was, there's a little collar on the screw, on the end of the screw. So this plate would actually need to be countersunk just slightly on the top hole. Would it fit in the bottom? No. It doesn't even fit in the bottom hole either. So both of those would need to be countersunk, or replace these with something else. So let's find that something else. RPM gearbox is installed. So the gearbox cover covers the gap where the old slash one leaves a little gap, so all the rubbish from the drive shaft can shoot straight up into your spur gear. So that's a real nice feature on this.
I mean, it's not a bad installation. It's not easy by a long shot. Definitely not one for amateurs. This is the first one I've done. It's taken me about 2.5 hours-ish. There's probably some places I could have saved some time. But yeah, overall, I'm pretty pleased with it. Definitely looks the part. I think I might stick a battery in and go and have a quick blast.